It's his 73rd birthday today. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you. Happy birthday. Thank you.
I'd really love to see you, especially on your birthday. In all his years in showbiz, he's never performed live in the UK.
That's about to change because you're playing Wembley Arena.
Yes, November the 24th with Gary Puckett, the Drifters, and the Foundations. I'm very, very excited, and I'm sorry it took me 50 years to get here.
What do you got here in the end?
But I don't think I'm going to leave, yeah.
Well, we're going to take a moment to have a little look back.
Okay.
Have a look.
I love that song. I love it particularly because of Dirty Dancing as well.
Yeah, I went to see the play Dirty Dancing last night. Very good.
Yeah?
Very good, yeah.
I mean, it must have been extraordinary for that to kind of, to bring, I guess, your music to a whole new audience as well.
Well, yeah, I mean, when they got me with Dirty, I was thinking about retiring. And that was 27 years ago, and now I'm still out here, and I'm singing Dirty. Time in my life, and now my daughter, who was born right when
time.
I did, at the time, she's out here now singing Time in My Life with me, so it's been an amazing 50 years.
Well, yeah, a moment ago, we were talking, weren't we, about Jimi Hendrix, and I just
yes.
mentioned that to you, and of course, suddenly you say, well, I met him, and I knew him.
Yeah, he was, I went into a small club out in California, and U.S. and he was playing guitar for Little Richard, and I got to meet him, and somebody told me years later, you know, that's the guitar player for Little Richard.
Was
I said, well, he did pretty good.
Was he good then?
Oh, God, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, he's a special guy.
And Elvis drove you in his car? That's nice to have happen.
Yeah,
as well,
well,
in your life.
Yeah, you know, I was recording in Memphis, and every night they would come and get me one of Elvis's guys and take me to Graceland. And one night Elvis says, we're going to the movies. I said, okay. And we go out to the driveway, and there's Elvis's limo. And Elvis says, get in the back seat. I said, well, okay. And so Elvis and Priscilla got in the front. And we started that long drive down, the driveway, and the people see that there's always about 200 people down there at the gates and at Graceland, and they start going crazy, and the doors open, and they're going nuts, and we drove right through about 300 people, and not one person looked in the front seat. They all looked in the back.
I've
never seen so many disappointed people
oh.
in my life. But it was Elvis, he knew that they wouldn't look in the front, so he just
I suppose when you've been in the business a long time as you have, and seen, you know, been in and around those kind of people, and your own success gives you a different kind of perspective on the music scene generally. And we talk now about sort of One Direction.
Oh, yeah.
The impact they're having in America, I know, which is
a lot
of imagination.
On fire.
But how do you compare those sort of eras,
Well, you know, I mean, it's oddly similar. I mean, you watch One Direction, and Bobby and I, the Righteous Brothers, were on the first American Beatle tour. So it's very similar.
You saw that firsthand?
Firsthand. Oh, boy, firsthand.
Go on,
man. Well, people always say, how was it to be the opening act for the Beatles? I said, can't tell you how it was to be in front of 30 or 40,000 screaming kids, clapping and screaming, clapping. And, we want the Beatles.
Oh,
man. Yeah, it was. That's the truth. It was a little tough. And then we went on the Rolling Stones' first American tour, and they hadn't made it as big yet. And so that was a great tour. Both tours were great. Beatles were great guys.
And so, I mean, we mentioned the fact that you've never performed here in the UK.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, is there a reason?
Well, there's a reason. We've always wanted to get here. I mean, we came here in 65 to promote Love and Feeling because Cilla Black had, not copied, but did Love and Feeling. And but while we were here promoting Love and Feeling, it exploded in the States. And by the time we got back home, they had us booked for about 3 years. And then the Righteous Brothers, we broke up for a little while, right about the time we were coming here.
Can I just say, in this clip here, you're clicking your fingers at different times.
Yeah, Bobby's on 1 and 3, which he would just hate that, and I'm on 2 and 4. I'm the hip one.
Okay.
We look very angry, don't we? We look thrilled with that. We were probably
thrilled to be there, obviously.
But we were thrilled to be there.
Yeah. So Wembley, so that's going to be quite something. And so your daughter sings with you as well, which is going to be lovely.
26, going to be 27 in February. Yeah, she's a real good singer. And
of all the famous songs, do you have a favorite? Or they?
Oh, they're all like children.
That's
know?
What people say.
Yeah, they
can't
really
choose.
But I guess Love and Feeling would have to be pretty special. And I've had the time of my life as special because it kind of kept me going a few more years.
And those kind of songs, I bet people say to you all the time, I was doing a certain thing, I got married, special moment to that music.
Yeah, a lot of naughty things. A lot of high schools were, I think junior high schools were created from some of those songs.
I know it's your birthday.
Oh, yes.
And listen, look, we prepared this.
Oh,
we really knew really late. We would have got a bigger one if we'd known a bit earlier. But there you go. We'll light it for you later.
Oh, God, how sweet of you.
Absolutely, isn't it?
You look very
happy
well
birthday.
For 73 years
thank
old.
Thank you.
Congratulations and happy birthday.
I guess the older you get, the smaller the cakes get.
I thought the one candle might be flattering.
We'll
light it
very
in a minute for you.
That's very sweet.
Thank you very much. It's lovely to meet you.
Just a reminder, Bill will be performing at Wembley Arena. 24th of November, you can see him on Later with Jules Holland tomorrow night, 11:05, that's on BBC Two.
Will you share the cake with us? Fair enough.